AuraStorm here, coming at you guys another video today. Before I get to the main topic of the video, which is the tech card, Hey Trunade, I want to talk about nationals. So I understand that the UK nationals just ended. I want to talk about the North American WCQ. Yes, I will be attending. So I believe it's next weekend. I will be there on Friday and Saturday. So if you guys want to chat, you know, hey, play some Yugimons, I will be there. I won't be competing in the actual event itself, but I'm just going to kind of go just run into people, meet with subscribers. I'm super excited because I've never been to a Nationals. It's my first time attending one and maybe the only time I'm able to attend one. So hope to run into some of you guys at the North American WCQ. But anyways, back to the main topic at hand, which is a tech card I saw in a couple of different videos that I've been watching, both the top tier Yu-Gi-Oh! and Jury Doll. Shout out to you guys. Talked about Hey Trunade. So this is a card that kind of flew under the radar for good reason. I'm going to talk about its strengths and its weaknesses and why I think it's actually a card you should definitely pick up and try in your side deck for the WCQ. So Hey Trunade originally came out in Extreme Force. Is a very simple spell. It's just a normal spell card that says return all set spells and traps on the field to the hand. So it's a lot different than the old Giant Trunade. This is the type of recreating cards I like, where Konami creates an old card but basically designs it so it's not the problem it was back in the day. And Hey Trunade is a great example because it hits set cards, it doesn't bounce face up cards. So you can continue to reuse them. So Hey Trunade is in an interesting spot because when it originally came out, the top decks at the time were pendulum based decks and spirals. Both decks, and then later on, of course, spirals were hit, and then pendulum became the best deck. The problem with Hey Trunade against these particular decks is they don't play any trap spell or traps that aren't set to bounce. And then we got, the Flames of Destruction, we got Altergeist, which also play a lot of continuous of back row that can't be bounced by Hey Trunade. We also have True Dracos, but at this point, now that we have Sky Strikers, it's a very good card against Sky Strikers. I'm going to explain why. So Sky Strikers are in some Trickstar Sky Strikers, kind of to the lesser extent. Both of these decks have one thing in common, is they play a lot of chainable back row, and that's where a card like Hey Trunade really shines. So Hey Trunade being able, most of the trap cards that a pure Sky Striker deck plays are cards like Widow Anchor, Solemn Strike, Infinite Impermanence, any of those cards. Getting those out of the way so you can make plays is huge against pure Sky Striker variants. Being able to get those cards out of the way so you can make plays and only have to worry about the hand traps is really, really big. And against the Trickstar Sky Striker variants, it's not as good, but it forces them to flip things preemptively, which is your goal in general. Not only will they have to, if they have anything like Widow Anchor set, it'll finish it up. But the other thing it does against the Trickstar variant is it forces them to activate their scapegoats and their reincarnations preemptively. And this is really good because it's a lot easier to deal with scapegoat tokens and get them off the board if you're not having to get it flipped on you in phase. You'd much rather have scapegoat flipped on you on your opponent in your main phase than your end phase. It's a really big difference. It makes a huge deal, in my opinion, in terms of what it does against the Trickstar variant. It's not as good. It's better against pure. But that's the main thing, is the best deck right now runs a lot of chainable back row. And that's where a card like Hey Trunade really, really shines in terms of just being able to get those chainable back rows off the board. Now, what are the flaws with this card? Because obviously, you know, there are no card is perfect. While it is really good against Trickstar Sky Striker, it's pretty good against pure Sky Striker. Trickstar variant is the most popular, and while it does, you know, force them to flip their reincarnation up preemptively, that's about all it, and gets the scapegoats flipped up preemptively. It doesn't really do enough because most variants don't play a lot of, you know, traditional trap cards. They might side impermanences, etc. But you're kind of like, and the other thing about against pure Sky Strikers is you're bouncing them to the hand, which means they can then reuse them on the following turn. You aren't removing the problem. Now, personally, I think it's better. It doesn't really matter unless you banish the Sky Striker spells and traps. It's kind of a moot point whether they're in the grave or on the field, because Kagari will just bring it back from the grave. So it's kind of a moot point. The fact is, you aren't really removing the threats from the equation. You're putting them back in their hand so they can reuse them on the following turn. And the other, Hey Trunade is the type of card, while it is really good for forcing and pushing damage OTKing, if you can't really, much like with a card like Red Reboot, you're not going to be killing your opponent that turn if you activate Red Reboot from hand. You probably shouldn't activate it, and that's kind of the thing with Hey Trunade, is you are taking a neg one to, you are getting all the back row out of the way and forcing them to chain it, but you aren't completely removing the threat. And the other thing, it's not really that good against any of the other decks you might run into. And when you are going to a big event like WCQ, not everyone is going to be playing the best deck, especially in the early rounds. And you might run into a lot of Trickstar Sky Strikers, but you also might play against a lot of anything, other things like Altergeist. Or you should, again, if you are playing Sky Striker Trickstars, you're going to beat them anyways. The whole point is, Hey Trunade just removes the threats off the board against that deck. And that's why I think Hey Trunade is a pretty good tech card, and I definitely think you should try it. So anyway, guys, that about comes the end of the video today. Let me know what you guys think of Hey Trunade. Would you side deck it against at the WCQ? Let me know down in the comment section below. And as always, I'd like to thank you guys for watching. So AuraStorm, signing out.